Out front tonight, Trump bowing even deeper to the prince, tweeting today, quote, oil prices getting lower. Great. Like a big tax cut for America and the world. Enjoy. 54 was just 82. He's referring to prices per barrel. Thank you to Saudi Arabia. But let's go lower. Thank you to Saudi Arabia, the same Saudi Arabia whose crown prince personally directed the murder of U.S. resident and journalist Jamal Khashoggi, according to the CIA. Now, the facts on oil. Saudi Arabia did increase its output of oil this summer, and prices are down. Down too much for Saudi Arabia, because here's what they've done. On November 11th, this month, the kingdom announced it's going to slash oil production by 500,000 barrels a day. Okay, when you cut production, it means there's less supply, prices go back up. They're slashing production because they want prices to go up, not down, because higher oil prices are good for Saudi Arabia, not the lower ones that President Trump says are the reason he's siding with the Saudis.
We are with Saudi Arabia. We're staying with Saudi Arabia. Because it's America first for me. It's all about America first.
Meantime, in Saudi Arabia, the Crown Prince's team is celebrating a victory over the CIA. Here's the foreign minister in an interview today.
What we've heard is the president say that the CIA report is not what people say it is. And so we have to go by this.
We heard the president say the CIA report is not what people say. The big question tonight is still why. Because the president's oil argument, of course, doesn't add up as a reason to side with Saudi Arabia, as we just showed. So why is he? Out front now, James Clapper, former director of national intelligence and CNN national security analyst. And Director Clapper, I appreciate your time. You know, the president today, the quote, let me say it again, thank you to Saudi Arabia. Why? Why is he doing this?
Aaron, I don't know. He's either gullible or disingenuous, and in either case, doesn't speak well of him. If anybody ought to be thanking anybody, it ought to be Mohammed bin Salman thanking the president for giving him a pass. And clearly the president has demonstrated that he is a show-me-the-money president. And this is not about America first. This comes out of Saudi first. And why this deference to yet another autocrat, I honestly don't know, unless they so successfully appeal to his ego that he can't do otherwise.
So I want to ask you about that in a moment, because there's a very explicit moment where they did try to do that, to appeal to his ego. But I want to ask you first about Adel al-Zubair, the Saudi foreign minister, a guy who knows Washington well, a guy who lived there a long time, right, former ambassador, seizing on Trump siding with the CIA. How significant is Trump doing that, siding with the CIA when it comes to Saudi? I mean, siding with Saudi against the CIA. I'm sorry, misspoke.
Yeah, well, Adel Jaber, of course, is grasping at any straw, and that's been the history of this whole episode with the Saudis, as they progress from one lie to the next. And so by the president's disregarding the intelligence on this, he has given the Saudis a hook, which Adel Jaber, who's a very shrewd guy, a long time in Washington, mm-hmm. Seized on right away. And again, it's just regrettable that the intelligence community kind of got thrown under the bus here.
Now, when you talk about appealing to his ego, Trump specifically mentioned his visit to Saudi Arabia as president, right, when he announced he is standing with the crown prince over the CIA. Now, when he visited, I want to show our viewers what he saw everywhere. Everywhere. And when, you know, those of us who have driven around Riyadh, I mean, you could put this picture up. It's just huge and it's everywhere. Yeah. Side by side, Donald Trump and the king. Did that work? That manipulation, was that successful?
Yes, and Aaron, and that's exactly what I had in mind when I said the successful Saudi appeal to his ego, and it had to do with that trip and literally rolling out the red carpet. Gold carpet and every other form of carpet, and this lavish treatment that he received, which seems to be the secret to success to garnering favor from the President of the United States these days.
So I want to ask you about this kind of shred that Adel Jubeir is clinging on to, and that the president has announced, you know, as sort of his reason for standing with Saudi Arabia. That the CIA has concluded that the Saudi crown prince directly ordered this horrific assassination. The words used are high confidence. You know, one former member of the CIA said to me, this is not them saying he might have done it or he could have done it, that he did it. And yet we don't know of any smoking gun. So when they say high confidence, what's your understanding, Director Clapper, of how sure they are? Is there a shred of doubt?
Very little. You're never 100% sure. That's not the nature of the intelligence business. But the agency clearly had multiple sources that gave them confidence in their conclusion. Moreover, anyone who has a fundamental understanding of how things work in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, where Mohammed bin Salman is into all things big and small. So it's completely inconceivable that an operation of this complexity involving killing somebody in another country was not only known to him and he acquiesced in it, but that he directed it. And so the evidence for this had to be overwhelming, and I believe that's what led to the characterization of their report being high confidence.
It does seem obviously like a statement of the obvious, as you point out, when you consider who was involved and the numbers and the private jets and, I mean, all of it. I mean, in a sense, it did seem almost absurd that we had to go through this exercise, but they did, and they did come to that conclusion. What's the harm, Director, that could come to this country or come out of this, of the President of the United States siding with, in this case, the Crown Prince of Saudi Arabia? Obviously, he's done it before with Vladimir Putin over the Russian intelligence. But in this case, what's the harm?
Well, I think it's a terrible, terrible commentary about our moral standing in the world and the way this is going to be looked at. And the president's, I think, again, disingenuous, if not dishonest, false choice here. If we condemn MBS, if we sanction Saudi, somehow they're going to turn against us. They're not going to do that. We have far more leverage over them than they do us. And they're going to continue to be an opponent of Iran in any event, just because they're kind of in the Sunni lead and the Iranians are the Shia lead. That's going to go on regardless of what we do. So all this false rationale for why he had to take this stand just doesn't cut it.
No, it doesn't. It doesn't make any sense. When you look at it, even from the numbers perspective and from the oil angle, it makes no sense. As he himself points out, the largest producer of oil now is the United States of America.
I would like to add, Aaron, just one more point that, I've said this before and I'll say it here, that the intelligence community, I believe, will continue to tee up truth to power, whether the power listens to the truth or not. And they'll continue to do that.
I hope they do, as, of course, the media tries to do as well, no matter what anyone calls it. Thank you so much, Director Clapper. I appreciate your time.